I see how the trip to Africa affected Muhammad Ali. How did it affect you?
How did the trip affect you? We see in the film how Ali is affected by Africa. What was your reaction to just being there?
My reaction was that at first I was concerned. I was concerned about my safety, and from the moment I got there, I went with Ali 2 weeks before the musicians flew over and what was happening in New York. I had a camera in New York, a camera in San Francisco. Foreman didn't come over until later. And question again was how it affected me. How can I say some of my best friends were African Americans, but some of my good, very close friends were people in sports, people in music, and people lived in the area that I lived in when I moved out to Jackson Heights, and it affected me in a very positive way. And how things fell into place. That song, When We Were Kings, David Sonnenberg had signed two young composers who really hadn't done anything, and they wrote that When We Were Kings, the film is still doing business, and we hope pays the mortgage. I live in Woodstock, and I have an editing room there. And my partner was sitting up there, Justin Martinez. We're doing a film now about Woodstock and how the artist colony was formed there in 1902, right up to the present. And tell me this.
We have a question right now. Yeah. Maybe you've already said it, but what is your most endearing moments with Muhammad Ali?
Say that again.
He asked for your most endearing moments with Ali. Maybe another moment you could talk about of your interaction. Your interaction with him, something, an anecdote.
Your most special moment.
Used to say to me, my remembrances are, what do you think, you're a new Howard Cosell? That one sticks in my head. I'd made some film, and a lot of people don't like a camera in their face. He never was anything but gracious and just was those so much of it is also there to make medicine sick. He had never said that one before. I had heard I'm so fast, I turn off the light in the bedroom. I was in the bed before the woman got done. But he had hundreds of them. And some of them were on the spot, just on the spot. He's an extremely bright person and generous. He took care of so many people. And continued to fight. He should have retired after the third Joe Frazier fight, but he kept on fighting. He fought 22 more fights after Zaire, and they weren't the kind of paydays today like Mayweather made $400 million from the Pacquiao fight. Pacquiao made $200 million on that fight. I don't think Ali's career was anywhere close to that kind of money. But there wasn't home pay-per-view at that time. It was closed circuit. You had to go to a theater and pay an admission, and they would broadcast the fight. And that way the promoters could control who's watching the fight, because they're being paid a licensing fee.
Over there.
Can you discuss your interactions with the Mobutu government while filming in Zaire, if you had any?
Yes. That was Mary McCabe.
Yes.
Miriam Makeba.
Miriam Makeba.
And I'll be Googling that sort of thing.
Fabulous singer.
And Miriam Makeba wound up as the delegate to the UN from Nigeria, I think. So she was in the UN, or she came by the editing room on Lens, somewhere on the Upper West Side, and the Secret Service accompanied her. There was some up on the roof, and some came into the screening, and she loved the film. And one of the things that happened was I didn't get releases from everybody. And now it's a very different situation with something called fair usage. If there's any filmmaker in the audience, or today there's something called fair usage, and you can use material if it fits the context of the film you're making. So if you're, let's say, doing a film about the movie business, it would fit under that law that you could use a clip from Gone with the Wind, a clip from On the Waterfront, a clip from any film you would like to use, as long as it's not in excess of a, you can't like use 5 minutes of a film, but you can use clips. And a clip can be 7 seconds, a clip can be 25 seconds. So fair usage today, and I'm the precedent for fair usage, is the film you just saw, When We Were Kings. And if anybody has that situation, and as a filmmaker, or maybe as a television fair usage, you can use, and you will see that the precedent is, Turner is going to broadcast it on a Monday, Wednesday, Friday night. They were doing an Ali special, and they were using several clips from that film, and at several minutes of it, more than clips. And one of Sonnenberg's lawyers found out about it. They were able to get a federal court in White Plains, New York, to hear it that Sunday. And I went there with, that time, a $20 an hour lawyer, and Turner had maybe 6 or 8 lawyers, and the judge ruled fair usage, and that became the precedent. He ruled in favor of Turner, and that's that fair usage now that so many filmmakers are using material and started by fair usage.
It's like a journalist having the ability to quote certain passages. I guess they wanted documentary filmmakers to have the same right to quote.
Yeah.
One or two more questions.
I have a two-part question. How did Ali feel about the vicious dictator of Zaire? I saw him kissing him in the film. You know, how is that? How did that work out?
She was saying the vicious dictator.
Ali
was seen kissing him. What was the relationship between Ali and the leader of Zaire? And the leader, the ruler of Zaire.
Mabubu did come out to inspect the stadium. Ali was there. I think that there was a, I think that everything seemed to fit. There were no problems. The major problem was that the cut happened, and the people involved with the fight is Foreman had a stay, Ali had a stay, and their trainers and all of those people had to stay. And I was able to leave. And I was gone for a week and got to do the Grateful Dead.
I had another question. Is the problem here?
The punch is electric.
One more question.
Touch it. And then it was, you don't want to go backstage. And there was a guy by the name of Owsley. I don't know if you remember that name. Owsley Acid. He was from Kentucky. It's a long time ago. Apparently I'm talking to a group of people. Going to my brother's funeral.
So I was wondering if this movie has been screened in the Congo, and if so, how it was received.
Has the movie been screened in the Congo, and how was it received there?
It was viewed there, and I heard with some of the people that I knew from that lived it, and now it is the Congo, but it was year after years, and it was viewed favorably all over Africa. I get to see the results. I own a piece of it, and it somehow filters down. So I see country by country the money that's made, and I can tell seeing if the Congo or maybe Liberia or Libya, and I'll see the number from Liberia is 3,000. This is total ticket sales, 3,125, let's say. And then I'll see France, and it will be $425. How's that possible? There were bootleg prints for sale in all the stores in France. So there are no receipts. The sales are bigger in Ireland and New Zealand than France. And it's still doing business around the world. And he was so much more than I had. It was just his generosity, how he just, over the years, I would meet people and I'd say, I have a story you're not going to believe. And I know that I'm going to believe it because I've heard so many stories about how he's helped people over the years. And there was a great turnout down in Louisville, and so many people had so many nice things to say about him. And he will, in a lot of people's minds, go down as one of the most important, influential people, and I'm sure some of you folks remember he was the Louisville Whip, and why didn't somebody finally shut him up? And there was a lot of negativity towards him, but he was sincere. He was really honest. And the reason he wound up in a, I wouldn't say desperate, but he gave anybody that could get close to him with a story would walk away with a check. So now there are professional athletes, and they have people who are like security people. I don't know about baseball, basketball, football players, what the sports, but I know the fighters. I know I did a Manny Pacquiao film, and I know that he had people close to him that just made sure that people couldn't get up and just tell their story about how my father is in trouble, he's out of that, he doesn't have the money for a lawyer, and Manny's a very generous guy, but not like Ali.
Would you join me in thanking